But first, let's have an update on the Labour leadership. And Mark Walker, political editor, is with me. Hi, Mark. Take me through it. What's happening there?
So, still ongoing. It's been a long process, this whole campaign, really. We're going to find out who the Labour leader is on the 4th of April. They'll be in place. So, obviously, the general election was, like, in December.
Right.
So, it's a long, old process there, and Jeremy Corbyn's still in place, as we know, as shadow leader, leader of the Labour Party. So, we've heard from two people. We've heard from Jeff Hemmings, and we've heard from Eddie Evans. And, basically, they're just talking about the front runner being Keir Starmer.
So the both of them predict that
Keir Starmer, well, at least being the front runner, because he seems to be the kind of the candidate who the Labour Party membership feel is best able to beat Boris Johnson at dispatch box, because there's not probably going to be an election anytime soon. Famous last words, but it looks like Boris is pretty secure. He's got a massive mandate there. A lot of things are going to have to go wrong for him not to be the Prime Minister for the next, few years.
Right.
So it's all about how can they dent the Conservative Party in terms of their policy, Brexit, how can they kind of make sure that the Tories have a credible Brexit policy, particularly with the trade negotiations, which is just about to start. So
it'll be interesting also to see what kind of style the Labour Party are going to, just a general style of handling themselves, because they have been kind of all over the place, in a sense, and they need to reinvent themselves in some way.
Yeah, exactly, because they're not as ruthless as the Tories. The Tories are pretty good at getting rid of their leaders. You know, if they're not, don't come up to scratch.
Are you saying they're nicer?
But Labour are nicer, possibly. Yeah.
It's different stuff.
Tories are much more about getting the right person in place and winning elections. It's like a election-winning machine, really. They've been in power for around 90 of the past 120 years have been a Tory administration, not Labour. Labour have been in power for about 30 years, I think, over the last 120 years. So Tories are more used to being in power, and they're much more ruthless, I think, in terms of ditching leaders and getting a new one in that can, deliver them that mandate which they want to govern the country. So maybe Labour have to be like that, and that's the big debate, isn't it? Do you let a leader, this is the crux of the issue, do you let a leader that is going to win the next election, or do you elect a leader who you think best represents your values?
Right.
And that's what it comes down to. Okay. The Tories more often go for someone that they think will play well at the ballot box, whereas Labour, maybe we could argue, they don't.
Right. And any implications as to Brighton, as to our area?
Well, obviously, Labour in the monitor administration, we've heard about the budget recently. That's been agreed upon, the budget for the Brighton Hove City Council. But they'll get a say in the leadership as well. All of the local branches, they're quite well affiliated, the local branches in Brighton Hove. Obviously, we've got two Labour MPs, don't forget, as well. We've got Peter Carl and we've got Lord Russell Moyle. So we're well represented by Labour. We're a bit of an outlier, really, because the rest of the South East is basically all blue. And we're kind of, on the South Coast, we've got two red MPs, two Labour MPs, and one Green, Caroline Lucas. And so we're a bit of an outlier.
Yes.
The rest of the South East votes Tory. We tend not to vote Tory here.
Right.
And they're in the council there. So we'll get a bit of more of a say maybe in other areas, because we've got more Labour members in Brighton than the rest of the South East, haven't we? So that's where we are at the moment. But as I said, we heard from Ellie and Jeff, and they've got their own spin on it, and we're going to hear more from Jeff Hemmings and Ellie Evans in the coming weeks. As we lead up to the, the final vote, and whoever that final Labour Party leader is, which is they're saying it's going to be Keir Starmer, so
we'll watch that space.
Watch that space.
Thank you so much, Mark.
Cheers.
Good.